is pretty much exactly what I wanted. Huh. What a great, dreary day. Okay. So here is what I'm going to try to do. That spot up there is right above the deck where I might sit. So the good news, it's really high up. So if I reach my hand, oh, it's as high as I can reach. Ooh, that is as high as I can reach. Okay, so if I'm gonna clean it, I need to be able to no higher than there. Okay, that's fine. So it's way above my head when I'm sitting. But here's why I want it to have a bottom on it. This is a pretty nice view. And see, I might put a matching one over there. My idea is that, and I can look that way. My idea is that they would have a nice long flight line from anywhere over there to this side of the aviary. And what I like is big open perches to land on for the big flight lines, and then they can reposition with the little futsy hopping and flying. So from over here, back over. Well, I'm about a third of the way, halfway through the aviary. So you can see it's going to be a nice long flight if I can get that set up. So that's what that's for. Oh, I can't wait to move them back in here. All right, so all right, so here's my thinking. I don't know the overall length. That should be like, let's say 3 feet or so. This will be 5.5 inches or whatever the finished size of the boards I get. Say that's 8 inches total. So that's a gap of 2 inches. Oh, that's why. Okay. So that's 1.5 inches. So the perch is going to be 3.5 inches above the floor. And it's going to be 3 inches or so away from the back wall, so there's plenty of room for their tail to hang down. Yeah, there's no way I can draw a bird. Yep. That's terrible. Okay, and then there's 2.5 inches to the front, so even if they're peeking around the corner, they won't be able to see who's over here. So that's good. The spacing between these should be, well, let's see if it's 36 inches total. 9 inches is too far. About 6. Yeah, 6 inches. So I'll have 6 of these. Lovely. Okay. So I need 1, 2, 3. I need 5 pieces. So that's 6. And these are 8. 5, 5 and a half. All right. So then I need a 8. Just need some kind of tray or shelf to slide in and out to clean. And now all I have to decide is, do I want a top on it and do I want a back on it and how to mount it. I don't want a top, I don't think. No, they're just going to perch on the top if I do that anyway. And then no light is going to get in there, so no top. What about a back? So where it's going to go in the aviary, there's a sliding window that's open, both above it and probably directly behind it. So in the winter, that's all going to be closed and draft free, but in the summer they're likely to be open. So is that a good thing? Maybe that's a good thing. Fresh air might be kind of cool in case it gets hot. Oh, and also the mister is up here around the corner, so maybe that's fine. Maybe they like to perch there and take a shower. Yeah, does that all make sense? Are my spacers. Now I need to drill out 1.5, 2.5. Perch is going to come through. My fancy assembly station. These are stainless steel soffit nails. They have a little coating on them to make it match, make it pretty. And I don't care about that, but they are stainless steel, which means they'll hold up nice to the environment. Oh, I forgot. I was going to cut these guys at an angle. Okay. Well, now I'm going to have to put some kind of thing across to secure them. Otherwise, they just spin on the post. Okay, let's figure that out. I know I'm going to have to measure these because I probably won't be content to just eyeball them, but I won't attach them just yet. It's possible I won't have to attach them. Okay, this time it seems to work okay. You know I want to measure those and make them correct. and about 3/8 off. Okay, just leave it. You don't have to fix that. There's nothing to be fixed. See, that's going to irritate, don't you think? Somebody lands on it, and then it bounces. And then somebody who is sleeping isn't going to like that. I just know it. All right, so what to do? Boy, I could try nailing into it, but they are really, really thin. Let's see if maybe we can just do one. So as long as we're doing that, we could just measure. There's no harm in measuring. Bouncy, just because I can't leave well enough alone. We'll say that that's the end of that. That's the poop tray. Here we go. Much less bouncy. I don't even know mine that it's bowed a little bit. It's okay. All right, so now how to hang it. Okay, so all I did is I put a 1x2 up here, which is the same as the trim up there, and spaced it out with another 1x2, so it should just kind of, should, sort of be a press fit kind of idea, hopefully not that tight, but let's pop this guy in. Nice. You know what? How does it look? That is pretty much exactly what I wanted. Huh. And you know what? It is going to be out of the wind. Maybe that's okay. Now the question is, could I reach the tray without the ladder? Whoa, just barely. Okay, that is gonna work, I think. It'd be nice to be able to slide it on and off without actually undoing anything. How could I do that? I'll think about that. All right, I think that'll wrap up this video. It's actually not hard to do. You could do it with hand tools, you know, or make a little. You've probably seen the one on the inside cages. It is a nice technique to try to eliminate maybe some strife in amongst birds. So, yeah, thanks for watching.